Good day to everyone. This is Dr. Sivaraman of iKnowIndustries.com. I'll be presenting the fourth webinar in this series of My Trading System in commemoration of the 10th anniversary of FX Trade. So this webinar is given on 21st of July between 12:30 to 13:15 GMT, and the topic is Market Players and the Limitations in Trading. So what sort of limitations you come across in trading? And you should be aware of all the limitations. If you want to become a really successful trader, it is not that you have developed a system to read the market and you are able to derive the forecast. So in between the cup and the lip, there can be so many ifs and buts, and there can be so many obstacles. So we should be able to understand, because you will be able to see the price action in the live market quote page that could be different from that of the trading platform. The trading platform can be slow or it can be fast. Sometimes you come across various complications. So I will be explaining that. Besides, also you come across the players have got big money, so they will be able to place big orders against us. It is very difficult for us to understand from time to time. So how exactly we can trade along with the players? By understanding their limitations rather than understanding their strength. So obviously a small person having a few thousand dollars trying to compare with that of a billionaire, obviously there is no comparison available and lifestyle will be totally different. But as human, even the billionaire will have its own limitation. So if you try to exploit such limitations, you will be able to attract the billionaire and the billionaire might be able to talk to us. So we have to find out what are the loopholes we find in such a system and try to exploit it in order to earn effectively from that other market. So it is more of a tactic rather than simply reading the market. So I will explain one by one with regard to the players or the operators. So market needs facilitators for the action. So if they don't give either way quotes in the market, market will be standstill and there may not be any up or down move or even a small swing for even doing a scalp trade. So they have to make necessarily either way quotes. That is what the feed providers give. They buy as well as sell, and you come across the spread is being established and the bid as well as the ask. So there could be a difference between the bid and the ask, and you call it as the spread. And this particular spread is not actually in the interbank treasury. The spread is being established by that of the brokers. So you need to understand, some brokers might be giving 1 pip spread and some might be giving 2 pip spread, some might be giving 3 pip spread, and they are all the systems generated by that of the trading platforms and the brokers, and that is their profit. So any trade you do, they try to take the profit out of that, whether you make loss or profit. Then subsequently, that particular portion of the spread, they try to share it with the IB who introduce and things like that. So don't ever imagine that platform providers, when they say that it is commission-free trading platform, it doesn't mean they are doing a social service. So you need the market facilitators, and the market facilitators try to give the either way quotes. If you are willing to sell, they are able to buy it from you. If you are willing to buy, they are able to sell it to you. So with which they are able to bring the momentum in the market. And also they induce the traders to participate. Then suddenly euro goes up, immediately you feel like you can enter into the market and gain about 20-30 bucks profit. So it is able to trigger you to participate in the market. If it is static, then suppose the euro is currently around 1.2818 and 1.2820, and you try to keep a buy order at 1.28 and somebody is keeping a sell order at 1.2850, you will not come for a compromise. But no trade will happen. And if they slightly gain the level by 5-10 pips, immediately you think that, oh, I may not be able to get it here, let me improve that level. And you try to place a higher bid. And then probably your order is being filled easily. So invariably you find that the market fluctuations or the market small swings are very much needed. Only then it will appear like a market. Otherwise, it will look like a dead market. And in that, how exactly the market players or the operators are playing a role. And you might have heard from many people that market, there are big players, especially the banks and the institutions, they place big orders. And you know the big orders, all the orders are to be routed through the bank. So ultimately the banks will be placing the orders. But the advantage for the bank to place order is, suppose euro is trading around 1.2820, they can keep a sell market order 1.2750 and it can trigger the market downward. Whereas in your trading platform, if you try to keep 1.2750 and it will just become a limit order, you will not be able to push down the market to a lower level. So that is possible with regard to the bank. So the players make use of that particular facility in order to bring the volatility in the market. So also they bring in the trend reversal, spikes, accumulation and distributions from time to time. So by using the big orders, they are able to bring the volatility. So up and down moves in the market. So you might have noticed that GBP was correcting from 1.53 area to that 1.5150 area, and suddenly it has gone up to 1.53. And so you will be able to understand how it is possible. How can the sentiments change so quickly within a matter of about 1 hour? That is possible by big orders. So when the players place their big orders in the market as a market order, and it can trigger all the lower level buys, and probably people who have kept the buy orders would have got the sell, but unfortunately they would have kept the sell limit order, in the sense the stops. So the stop would have been filled as well. So invariably what happens when they continuously drop about 50-60 pips, then a buy order is triggered and subsequently a stop for the buy order is also triggered. So they sell it to them at a lower level and still below that they try to buy back. So in that process, the person who has kept the order and the stop loses the money. That money belongs to that particular group of players. So obviously they have to trigger the market and bring in volatility in the market. Only then they will be able to earn money. So they create the market sentiment, as I explained in the previous webinar, and act against the traders, and that particular act becomes the trend reversal. So invariably when you use the conventional technical analysis, you fail to recognize that when exactly the intraday trend reversal or the long term trend reversal are expected to happen, because it is extremely difficult to identify the time frame. So when exactly it is going to happen, during my sleep or when I am watching the market or when I am doing some other work it is going to happen, you won't be knowing it. But obviously you need to identify that they are known to make trend reversals in the market. Also they are known to make quick moves in the market, the spikes. The spikes are nothing but the quick moves, and according to my definitions, the spikes, they go to the extreme level of about 150 pips rise or 150 pips fall in the case of euro. That sort of move, they do it in just a matter of about 1 to 1.5 hours, then it is referred as a spike. So they try to drop the market and accumulate the positions and quickly make the spike and distribute the positions on a daily basis. And in that process, they bring in various quantities. If they want to spike up the market continuously upward, they sell less and buy more, sell less and buy more, and that sort of strategy they do it and try to gain the levels and finally distribute the positions in the market. So these players, they are all the richest in the richest of the in the world. So obviously their money need to earn money from that other market. And they are not believing in a system of converting the money into that of effort and the effort to that of the money back. So normally anybody who is interested in converting the money into effort, then they will go in for a business establishment. They will try to establish a business and try to put in hard work and try to convert, initially convert the money into that of infrastructure, and also hire the people and extract the effort from that of the hired people and try to capitalize it by selling it at a higher level or earn money from that of that particular business establishment. Whereas the richest of the richest, they are not willing to invest their money in such a type of business model. Probably a small portion might be invested, but they want the money to multiply and the money to earn money without converting their effort. So invariably you come across in that scenario they deploy the money to rig the market, and we have to understand that we have no say and we cannot control them. And only possibility is we need to identify their limitations, and we have to necessarily earn successfully from that market. That is our objective, focus on it. But this is limitation we have to face. And the only alternative to trade in the market is trade along with that of the big players. So when you trade along with that of the big players, obviously understanding their limitations, they will not be able to curb you earning money from that of the market. Then the either way codes are needed in the market, because you need that. Every platform says that we have the feeds from our 6 banks, 7 banks, 8 banks, etc. What is that? They're all nothing but the either way codes. So somebody is selling, somebody is buying, and that sort of codes will be available in the trading platform. Then they will say there is a definite kill possibility. So either way codes are needed from the banks for the trades to happen. But invariably what the players do is they do the circular trade. There comes the difference. So what is circular trade? They are the buyer, they are the seller. That is circular trade. From one terminal they place the buy order, from another terminal they sell it to that. So obviously you will be wondering why the market is dropping, but they will be simply selling it to their own people who have kept the buy orders at the lower level. In the process, some of the people who have kept the buy orders will also get filled. Some of the people who have got the stops also get filled. But ultimately what do you come across? Predominant of the volume is of a circular trade. So when you see the entire market volume, when they are top in terms of trillions, you will find 2/3 of the volume is of the players. And only 1/3 of the volume of the market is of the traders. So they need to deploy 2 times of the total market volume in order to rig the market. That is what they are identified, and they are trying to do it successfully, and they are able to earn effectively from that of the small traders. So it is a question of money power. The players trade against the traders. So that is what you come across. So when whether there is a no deal room and deal room and things like that, the players will, their platform providers may say that we don't have any manipulation. Oh, at platform level, they are not doing manipulation, but at bank level, they are doing the manipulation. So we have to identify what you could come across in the live market quote page. There might be a difference. If you carefully watch the live market quote page and the rates which are given in your trading platform, sometimes you will find the rates are slightly higher than that of the live market quote page. Sometimes it might be lower. So you'll be wondering why. That is how they manipulate it. So in the platform level, they will try to earn from that of their clients. So it is an open card game wherein the traders' pending positions are known to that of the players. So in this open card game, you should be able to earn. So it is a constraint, but still we can overcome it, because they are also human, we are also human. We have to use our intelligence to counteract rather than trying to fight against them. So hence they make the decision extended rise or the fall. So when euro has dropped to 1.18, everybody was talking about the Greece problem. They just aggravated the feel among that of the traders and dropped. And nobody bothered to question, okay, when the market is dropping, everybody is willing to sell, but who is buying at those levels? And some people would have given that answer, that those who have taken the higher level sales will be buying at the lower level. But that is not the true answer. But actually they drop forcibly by circular trades and try to buy and hold it at a lower level. See, yesterday when I was giving this webinar, and euro was trading around 1.30, and from there it has come to 1.28. At 1.30, what the players have done, they created the bullish feel and just offloaded, distributed their position, and around 1.28 they are trying to hold the buy orders and trying to buy when people are distressed and thinking that it is going to fall further down and selling to them. So they buy and sell at a range of 300 to 500 pips. So we need to understand their strategy. Only then we will be able to develop our own strategy. Then we need to be aware of their tricks. The false moves before the intentional moves. And you would have seen that during this early European session, they made quickly a rise in the case of GBP. And when GBP was used to create the bullish feel, you should understand, okay, they wanted to upload. When they stopped cutting the high for more than 30 minutes, if they have taken a sell position, you will be seeing profit now. So we need to find, okay, what are the limitations and then exploit it. Then if you think that, okay, I missed the buzz in taking buy position in GBP, it has gone to 1.53. Let me take a buy position in 1.290 so that it will also go to 1.30. You try to make a relative comparison and try to take a position. So it has not gone up. So the next thing is rise in euro. Then it would have dropped to 1.28. So this is how you come across the market continues to give surprise. So you have to identify that. Why they have dropped euro and why they have gained the levels in GBP. It is a simple mechanism of dropping euro GBP. When they are focusing on euro GBP, if you try to take position in euro or GBP, just like that, you might be deceived. So you have to identify what currency pair they are playing at the moment. Then subsequently, you should be able to take positions when they start playing in the interested currency of yours. Limitations of players should become our advantage. What? They cannot rise more than 150 pips or 150 pips drop in a given day. That is indicated in a net change. So currently you come across euro has got a net change of 68 pips negative. If you use your live market put page, you will be able to see that. And I have given the link on a daily basis, so I am not giving the link here. Then you come across that it has dropped about 67 pips. So there is another potency of about 80 to 90 pips drop in the case of euro. So don't be in a hurry to take a buy position in euro. After they completely dropped it and they stopped cutting the low, then try to take a buy position. Without listening to anybody, then you find that next day in a pullback, you will be able to book profit. Or towards the close, when they make a pullback, you will be able to book profit. So this you need to understand. By understanding their limitations, we should try to trade. Then constraint we could play phase in platform. This is the most important thing before choosing the platform provider, because without a platform you will not be able to trade. There are some people who trade through banks and that is not online trading, so you have to call the bank and do it. Obviously you require more equity to do trades because the margin what they collect is much more. It is about 1:30 or 1:50 and things like that. So obviously you need to deploy more money to participate in trading. There again, you have to give the call to that of the bank. The dealer should be able to attend to your call and there are a lot of limitations. So, predominant of the traders are using their trading platforms. So, obviously, I am going to discuss with regard to the constraints or the limitations when you are using the online trading platforms. So, in the online trading platforms, you come across, not in all the trading platforms, but these are all the common terminologies which are being used in the financial market when the online trading platform is available. So some trading platform might be using one or two and certain other platforms might be using all of them and things like that. You should be able to discriminate and identify the right type of trading platform for your trading. This is very important. Your success and the defeat in forex trading depends upon your trading platform and what are the facilities you have in the trading platform. The common thing what you come across in the trading platform, namely slippage. Suppose you keep a buy order and they will say that we are not able to fill it and they will say that at a higher level they are willing to fill it or you are willing to take it. This is what you come across. That is referred as a slippage. In case if you want to sell it, that if you want to sell you at 1.2822, then they will say it is available at 1.2810 or you willing to take. That is what they will ask. And you come across a slippage about 2 to 3 pips, sometimes 5 to 10 pips. When the market is very, very active, you will find during the data release time, then you keep a hedge order, you keep any stop, they will not give a definite fill to that of the stop. Instead, wherever the market rests after the complete spike, then they will say it is available at that level. Otherwise, if the margin is low, they would have simply applied margin calling. Then the recode. And when you try to take a market order, they will try to give a recode or give a wrong fill sometimes. Suppose you keep a buy order at 1.2807, they will simply fill it at 1.2810 and calmly keep quiet. So if you chat with the dealer or call the dealer and he will not give a proper reply. and you might have seen out of your experience, before opening the trading platform, the marketing people will be talking to you so nicely. And after that, once you open a real trading account, the dealers in the deal room or who are in charge of the trading will talk to you. It might be very, very rubbish talk. And you might be asking one question, you will be giving a different reply. This is the strategy. They are using it like a call center. And they will repeat that reply like a parrot. Then order rejection, which is another thing. Once you place the order, simply the order will get rejected, even though the market has passed through that particular level. Then the spread. You come across a spread nowadays. It is a strategy. Many of the trading platforms, they are using it. Whenever the market is closer to the of the data release, the spread becomes variable. So they say the spread is 2 pips or 1 pip. At the time of data release, the spread between the bid and the ask will become about 20 pips. Suddenly it will become 20 pips, you will not be able to trade. Simple. So, they say definite spread, but ultimately you come across variable spread. Then another killing effect is the overnight interest. So the overnight interest will also fluctuate depending upon the supply and the demand. And when you are not willing to cut the loss making positions, and they will charge more interest for you, inducing you, and that interest will be taken out from that of the usable margin. You will find the usable margin is getting eroded, and you know very well the market after drop is going to rise, but the platform will not allow you to hold the position for even for about 5-10 days, especially when you are done over trading. If you are having one lot position, obviously you will not come across any problem. They may charge about $1, $2 as the interest, but that is not going to affect you. But if you take several positions, then all positions will be charged with the interest, and you have to address to that. Then depositing and withdrawing the money. There might be too many stories, and you come across reviews in various websites with regard to various trading platforms. You come across some of the disputes and things like that might be imaginary, and certain other disputes might be genuine. You should be able to discriminate with regard to the reviews and the compliance, because ultimately nothing is brought to the light, because the person who has lost the money will think that it is my bad luck, I lost it. So what is the fun in fighting with the trading platform? It simply goes away. Only very few people just refer the matter to some of the regulators and try to get a resolution for that. But there again, it is a very, very long process. These are all real constraints when you are trading, so you have to address to that. Then also you come across the platform freeze, and some of the platforms which the server is not adequately supportive, and more orders are being placed, simply the platform will freeze. Then orders will be simply rejected. So keep in mind, these sort of constraints we might be facing it. I am not talking negative, and these are all the potentials in the market. Keep that in mind and try to do trading. That is why I always say that don't overtrade and take only one little position and try to earn money out of that, then subsequently think on another position. Whether you buy Hero at 1.28 and book profit at 1.29, or you buy it at 1.29 and book profit at 1.30, ultimately you are going to earn about 100 pips. So the levels don't give importance. You try to see how much of profit I will be able to earn. Identify the profit potency, then try to enter into the market. Then you come across various market regulators. So I'm not going to talk anything about the various regulators, because they are above all of us. So obviously, if you try to make a comment, then you will be facing constraints or problems. But I can tell you one thing. There are so many claims, or so many traders who opened accounts with various types of trading platforms, and simply the regulators close all the pending positions and capture the money, and pending disputes are there for several years and it has not been addressed properly. But the platform provider or the feed provider might have done a mistake, or might have not kept the adequate the capital and things like that, paid up capital, but still the victims are the traders. So whether just because it is NFA regulator or FSA regulator or any regulator, doesn't mean that you are not facing any risk there. So the best thing is, if you want to hold the position for a long time, then only hold one position. In case if suddenly they close all the positions, you might lose only in one position. Still, you will be able to earn that money by going to another trading platform. But if you have several positions and exhausted most of your usable margin, and if they suddenly act on you, then you become helpless. So you may come across various websites giving a definite fill statement. But definite fill might be a higher quote when compared to the other market. So I'm not trying to criticize the platform. I reviewed various types of platforms for my interest and found. And I do not recommend any trading platform for trading when the clients or anybody ask me, for the simple reason that in every trading platform I have found some sort of defect or not, some sort of shortcomings or not. So it is up to the trader to choose the platform and identify the limitations of the trading platform and try to develop a system so that you will be able to effectively come out of it, and it will not be a big setback for you. And there are other trading platforms, they call it as market makers. They trade against you and they simply get the feed from that other bank, and they don't give your orders to that other interbank treasury, and they trade against you. And in the event when they trade against you, obviously when you make money, they have to pay you. And they know very well, based on the logistics, 95% of the traders lose money in the market, so they are very successful. But in the event if somebody makes money and they have their own trick, then no deal room platform. It doesn't mean that the platform does not have a deal room, so it will be a very safe trading platform. Don't think like that, because the banks can do similar strategies against you. Then the spread, but no commission. They are all explained to you that spread is nothing but the profit to that of the bank as well as the platform providers, and also the IB and the feed providers. Everybody is trying to take a stake in your trading. And the bank deal rooms trades at higher margins, like 1:100, 1:200, 1:400. You find that the leverage everybody is talking about is riskier. Like 1:400 is rubbish, that is what many people say. 1:50, and the NFA is trying to reduce it to 1:10 or 1:20 and things like that. But as long as you take only one position at a time and try to trade and earn money out of that, and subsequently think of another position, use the right trading strategy to limit the risk and maximize the profit, the leverage does not play a role. Why they are restricting the leverage? Because a new trader who comes in finds that only $50 is taken for one mini lot, or $25 is taken for one mini lot position. If it is 1:400, then obviously the remaining money will be available in the usable margin. Then he is tempted to take more average position. But if they are well educated and ask them, and if the traders are being explained very clearly all the risk involved in trading and advised to take only one position at a time, one mini lot or one lot depending upon the use of the margin, and try to book profit, and these constraints, the leverage constraint, does not come into the picture at all, then online trading and its limitation. So besides the trading platform, we have our local constraints, namely the internet and the system failure. Suddenly your computer can crash or freeze because of the memory problem, and sometimes the internet can create problems. So envisage that when you wanted to, if you think that you can always place a market order, suddenly the internet goes, you will be really handicapped. So as soon as you place a buy order or a sell order, and see that you are also placing the stop along with it. So in the event the internet is disconnected, still your loss is being determined. And your profit is also determined when you keep the limit. So we cannot watch the market 24 hours. It is impossible to human to watch the market all that 120 hours of the market, right from Sunday night to Friday evening. So it is next to impossible. So obviously you have to undergo sleep and you have to do other activities. So understand our limitations and try to do trade when you are available for trading, and don't try to take chances. Then change in the lifestyle, facing helpless condition, then need to attend other work. Invariably, if you desire to place only market orders, then you will be glued to that of your computer. You will not be able to attend to any of the work. If your wife is calling, you will say, just wait, I'll come in half an hour. That might be an emergency. Still, you will simply say, wait, because you give importance to what? Market, rather than your family. You are trying to earn money in order to save your family and support your family, but you make your family helpless. So understand that limitation. Then yelling at the computer, whenever the trade goes wrong, you shout at the computer. The computer does not listen to you. And the expression of irritation and the impulsive act, just throwing something on the computer or throwing something on the TV and things like that doesn't help. You are only loser. So obviously, when you shout at it, your emotion is being expressed out. Later on, you realize that you have done something wrong. But you have to understand that you should not repeat such thing. Then decide the type of trade. So whether you want to do a swing trade, intraday trade, or a position trade, plan it well. When the swing trade going is good, then try to convert into a position trade. Rather than hold a loss making position and say that, no, I am only interested in position trade. That means you are trying to cheat yourself. After the position makes profit, you keep stop at entry and wait for 2-3 days so that you will be able to maximize the profit to 150 pips or 350 pips and participate in the trend and try to earn the maximum out of that. Those things are possible after keeping stop at entry. Not simply holding the position which is making about 200-300 pips loss, or sometimes there are people holding about 700-800 pips loss position simply without using hedging. So always try to choose a platform wherein the advantages are available. Whether you use the hedging or not, see that you are choosing a platform which has got a hedging facility. Why? Because in the event of crisis or in the event of the crisis management, suddenly the market makes a very big move and you will not be simply watching that position which is just taking away your usable margin. Instead, you can straight away hedge. Otherwise, you have to close the position. And even if you try to close the position, they may not give a definite fill. Understand that. And if you have a hedging facility, okay, I am taking a position here. I can withstand a loss of about 100 to 200 pips. Doesn't matter. Keep at least a hedging order, 150 pips below that your buy entry. So that in the event if the market goes against you, just your position is hedged. The money is blocked, but the money is not lost. I will talk more about usage of hedging in subsequent trading strategy webinar. So the trader has to choose the right type of platform wherein the hazards are minimal, and always question when the marketing people contact you and ask these questions whether they are able to provide a safe fill and things like that. Ask them and don't trust it. And you try to test it in a real trading platform using a small money and see how exactly the platform is working for you. Then subsequently put in more money and don't straight away open with a big money and later on you find it extremely difficult to withdraw that money. Then also see that what is the available equity for you, and only within the limit of the equity. Try to take only 1% of your equity for taking trades. And try to build your profit slowly, because nothing can be achieved overnight. You have to build and it has to undergo the process of money making. Then also you try to choose the time you can spend in trading and only confine to do the trading during that particular time. So don't make your time miserable by choosing the wrong or the odd time. And how to overcome such limitations, because I should not simply highlight the problems alone, I should also explain how to overcome. And keep contingency plan always, limit the risk while placing orders, trade only when free, so that free time, then wait for the good opportunity, rather than trying to take a position and trade, wait for the position to show profit, you wait for a quick move in the market. So whenever you come across quick moves, understand that they want to do reverse. So obviously the quick moves will be for about 3 stages. Wait for all the 3 stages to get completed, either it's on the downside or on the upside. Then afterwards try to enter into the market. You will be able to keep stop at entry at least. Then avoid become addicted to trading. This is most important thing. And You feel restless when you hold, when you don't hold any position. That is a very wrong attitude. So you are here to make money from that other market, not simply holding some position, talking about euro and just giving the glory of euro and things like that. When ECB is not worrying about the glorification of euro, why you worry about it? You have to think about it. So you have to understand that we are here only to trade and not to unnecessarily spend all of our thinking ability pertaining to the economic conditions, etc., which are all the work of the government bodies. Then fine-tune the entry. In case if the platform is giving slippage and things like that, you try to keep about 5 pips or 10 pips below that of the market, a buy entry order or a sell entry order, keep a limit order so that they have to give a definite fill instead of taking a market order. Then similarly, stop, entry stop, etc., exit, you try to give the limit order rather than trying to close the position of the market. So if you avoid doing the market trade, then you'll be able to find that the fine tuning is possible. Then avoid placing market order. Use hedging when the position makes initial loss. As soon as the position is taken, it will make the spread of the currency as a loss. Then try to keep the stop or the hedging order. In case if you use the hedging order, then you will have both the positions and your money is blocked. It is equal to loss. But only thing is you will get time to close the hedging along with that of the original position after realizing where exactly the market is going. Whereas if you keep a stop, then immediately the position is closed, then it leads to open condition. Then use the trailing stop when the position is making profit. So use hedging order to limit the risk where as soon as the position is taken, then keep stop at entry and trail the stop in order to maximize the profit. And you know that the players also understand that you will also use the trailing stop. So obviously, even if the trailing stop is 20 pips away, the platform sometimes might fill it. So identify what sort of strategies they are doing it and try to keep the trailing stop away from that so that they will not be able to give a fill for that when the going is good for you. Then limit can be moved away from that other market to maximize the profit. And suppose you have kept 50 pips limit and the trailing stop is already blocked about 30 pips profit for you. And you can move the limit to 75 pips or 80 pips and see how exactly the going is. Because your initial profit target of 30 pips is being achieved by the trailing stop. Still it is not filled. Then leave the limit and take the limit away from it and see how exactly you are able to get that. Then determine the risk while taking a position. So how much of risk I can take? This is very, very important for anybody. And after an unexpected risk, you should not think that, no, I am helpless. And if you are helpless, only you can help yourself. Nobody else can pass through the computer and come to your premises and give you a help. Understand that. So be an opportunistic trader rather than trying to take the position and look for an opportunity. And whenever a good opportunity is seen, then you trade. Then you will be able to eventually earn money from the market. Then even the spread may be wider in some trading platform. Don't go by that. It has to be 1 pip or 0.5 pips and things like that. Whether you come across a safe trading environment in that particular trading platform, the fair execution of that position is important. And the honesty of the trading platform providers is utmost important whether they are regulated or not regulated. You come across so many platforms in the US, they are being closed because the owners of the platforms were dishonest. So whether it is being regulated or not, your money will not be safe. Unless and otherwise the platform provider is honest and is willing to sustain in the business for years together rather than do the business like a fly-by-wire. Then leverage can be more, but we can limit the positions. Take only one position at a time. Hedging limits the risk, then stop. I'll explain more about hedging in subsequent webinar. The slippage can be handled by using limit orders rather than taking the market order. Fine tuning of the order placement based on the constraints of the platform. It might vary from platform to platform. There is no point in blaming the platform providers because they can earn money only from that of their clients. They cannot earn money from that of the market because they don't do the self trade. they only ask others to trade in their platform. So you have to understand, they can only earn from their clients. It is not a mistake. But some people try to take an advantage of that. Right? You have to identify and trade smartly. They develop a mindset to accept a loss when it is small and avoid margin call. When the margin call comes, you know, the platform provider holds all your positions and they close the first come, first serve. So your first position will be the highest loss making position that will be closed. Instead, when you find there could be a margin call, either you add margin to the account or simply close some of the less loss making positions so that the margin improves, because the blocked margin for taking position is getting released. So that way you will be able to really come out of it successfully and pump in the money. And you have to see that whether you are able to pump in the money instantaneously using credit card or some of the wire transfers, etc. These are all the other facilities you have to see. And similarly with regard to the withdrawal. If there are any questions, I'll just go through that of the questions here. I just minimize the platform. So I don't have much time. Eddie is going to present his next webinar. So what type of platform will allow us to see the different levels of pending orders? No platform will be able to show. I mean, pending orders you can place it. If you are placing a limit order, in the platform you will come across a window wherein the pending orders will be displayed. Have you by any chance written a review of some of these platforms? No, I do not want to comment the platform, because they are trying to express their smartness. Nothing more than that. And so if they are probably earning from that of the traders, it might be the initial stage. And subsequently, when they are in well established, probably some of the practice traders just left it. So you will not be able to give a permanent review of the platform. Before opening account, you try to review the platform by yourself by keeping a small margin and see how exactly the trades are being executed. Then do you recommend a one lot per trade of 50,000, and can you still do 5 to 10%? Yeah, it is still possible, sir. You see that you will be able to really earn very good money if you are trying to take very less position, so that your mind will be free to maximize the profit. Rather than doing about 10 trades and earn about 150 pips profit, you can just do that by using one simple trade. It's possible. Then are these platform providers connected with each other to manipulate like players? No, not at all. Do the platform providers disclose traders' position with each other? No, not at all. Whatever you come across, it might be the secret with regard to the trading platform, and the true information, they may not be divulging it. Because if they divulge the true information, people can identify how many traders are trading in that particular platform. And probably it might affect their positioning in the market if they actually disclose all the details. And if you ask any platform, they will say, we have about 20,000 clients, we have about 30,000 clients. So no more explanation on that, please. What? And suddenly you will find that one day they will close down the platform. Later on you realize that they don't have any clients. What exactly is the trailing stop? And will all the platform offer them? There are some platforms. That is why I told you, the trailing stop, trailing hedging orders, and limit order placement, OCO orders. There are so many facilities, you know, the platform can provide. You see which particular platform is offering all those things, so that you will be able to really maneuver and earn maximum out of your trade. It is not that simply the forecast alone is enough for you. You need to find in between the constraints and try to address those constraints also. What exactly is the trailing stop? The stop which automatically trails along with it as a market. And when the market reverses, it stops. Okay, it's been explained. How do all these platforms get almost to the same price when there is no central? No, the platforms get the codes from that of the banks. So the banks are all linked and they provide the codes, and that is why you come across the coordinated codes here, even though it is not centralized. and all the trades are being executed in the interbank treasury, or it is, they are being reported to the interbank treasury. I think no more questions here. So let me go back to that of the slide, please. So hope you are able to do it. So let me show the last slide. I don't want to take more time. So I wish to thank FX Trade and the participants here. I shared some of my experiences and the ideas and with regard to the constraints. So in all the four webinars, I just explained what are the limitations a trader could face, how the market is structured, and what are the timings followed by the market, and what is our psychology, and how to control our emotions, and finally, in between, what are the constraints. These constraints can also create the panicness for us, or uncertainty, restlessness for us. So understand that before, so don't become surprised when suddenly you come across a slippage and a spike and the order has not been filled, etc. These are all part of the game. So accept that as part of the game. So after understanding all the limitations, we are going for the next topic, market readings and forecast. How exactly we can develop our forecast, how exactly we can read the intentions of the players from their market moves. I'll be explaining in my next webinar. And that will be pertaining to that of the forecast, and I will show you live how exactly we can read the intentions of the players, and we will be able to see that. I have been doing it in the Tracking the Forex Market Together webinar, but still I will demonstrate before you how we can read their intention. Then subsequently, I will also explain the trading strategies, because our reading may not be 100% right. It can be 95% right, still 5% error will be there. And we should not take a position in that error time frame and lose money. So we need to necessarily use the trading strategy. In subsequent webinars, I'll explain to you all. So I take this opportunity. Thank everybody. And see you again next week to continue the webinars pertaining to my trading system. I hand over the mic to Advanced Week to continue. Thank you, Onidog.